Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Samantha Smith. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for the first place winner of the Bermuda Idol, Miss Samantha Smith.
As we come to the end, almost the end of the evening, I'd like to introduce someone who is definitely no stranger to any of us. And as a result of his department, this is why we have this event taking place. At this time, I'd like to introduce to you Mr. Norbert Simons, the Director of Community, Culture, and Sports.
Good evening. Protocol hadn't been established. I just want to make one correction. It's the Department of Youth, Sport, and Recreation. We have a permanent secretary for community affairs and sport. Tonight, I'm not going to pontificate tonight, so we're going to go right to it. Tonight, we want to introduce to you the Junior Athlete of the Year, Female Athlete of the Year.
The Athlete of the Year Awards are the most prestigious honors to be bestowed upon the most competitive male and female athletes for their outstanding accomplishments during the current sports year. The athlete should have placed in the top four positions at a recognized international competition, should have advanced in the final grouping stage at a major competition, or placed first in a national competition. Ladies and gentlemen, we present the nominees for the Athlete of the Year. Cecilia Wolman is the 2014 Open BIC North American champion. In 2014, Cecilia qualified for the Youth Olympiad in Nanjing, China, where she amassed four top five finishes in the Bight Regattas. She further extended her sailing credentials by placing seventh in the 2014 CAC Games in Veracruz, Mexico, in laser radials. Cecilia's astounding performances have enabled her to be recognized by the Bermuda Olympic Association as a Category C elite athlete. Tonight, we congratulate Cecilia Wolman on her nomination. Our second nominee for the Female Junior Athlete of the Year hails from the sport of track and field. Fahima Scraters is a prolific athlete who has represented Bermuda valiantly at the junior level. At the 2014 Caribbean Games in Martinique, she obtained two medals, gold and silver, respectively. Similarly, she copped gold in the 400 meters at the 2014 CAC Junior Championships. Fahima is no stranger to local high school competitions, and in 2014, she emerged as the KPMG Front Street Mile High School Girls Champion. She qualified for the 2014 Olympic Games in Nanjing, China, and won the B Finals. Fahima is Bermuda's current female junior record holder in the 800 and 1500 meters. Tonight, we congratulate Fahima Scraters on her nomination. Our third nominee for the Female Junior Athlete of the Year hails from the sport of swimming. Ashley Irby is known for her amazing feats in water, both locally and internationally. She competed at the 2014 Carifta Swimming Championships in Aruba and amassed one gold and two bronze medals. She competed at the Caribbean Island Swimming Championships in Barbados and won two silver medals. In the 11 to 12 girls age group, she has set four long course and two short course records. At the local level, she won the KPMG Middle School Girls Finals and set a new race record. Tonight, we congratulate Ashley Irby on her nomination.
The Female Athlete of the Year, Junior Athlete of the Year, Kyra Scraters.
To thank the Bermuda National Athletic Association, Bermuda Olympic Association, my family, my friends, my mama, my coach for having training at 7:30 this morning. And this is my third time winning, and I'd just like to thank Bermuda Pacers, where I started. Thank you. I feel honored and blessed to get this award for the third time because I was up against a lot, both Cece and Ashley, who are really good athletes, and tried the best this year, so I'm just honored and blessed.
Our first nominee for the Male Junior Athlete of the Year hails from the sport of triathlon. Tyler Smith qualified for the 2014 Youth Olympic Games in Nanjing, China, and placed 19th in a very strong field. He competed in the Caribbean Junior Cycling Championships, placing second in the time trials and second in the road race. He won the Good Friday Triathlon All Ages Championships, the Bermuda Bicycling Association's Junior Criterion Championship, and the International 10K Junior Division during the International Race Weekend. Tonight, we congratulate Tyler Smith on his nomination. Our second nominee for the Male Junior Athlete of the Year hails from the sport of track and field. Kyle Webb is Bermuda's current male junior record holder in the 100 and 400 meters. He competed in the CAC Junior Championships in Mexico, placing third in the 100-meter finals. He won the Tampa Sun Angel Classic 200 meters in a time of 20.97 seconds, and the 400 meters at MESA NJCAA Championships in a time of 46.89, which saw him qualify for a World Juniors. Tonight, we congratulate Kyle Webb on his nomination. Our third nominee for the Male Junior Athlete of the Year hails from the sport of swimming. Jesse Washington is a 2014 Charifta swimming champion who amassed 2 gold medals, 1 silver medal, and 1 bronze medal. During the Caribbean Island Swimming Championships, he won 2 gold medals and 2 silver medals. He qualified for the 2014 Youth Olympic Games in Nanjing, China, placing 34th in the 100-meter freestyle and 23rd in the 100-meter butterfly. Jesse also qualified for the Canadian Age Group Championships and placed 4th in the 100-meter butterfly. Tonight, we congratulate Jesse Washington on his nomination.
Madam Minister, with all this smoke, I hope we didn't have to call the ambassador to get tested. Madam Minister, ladies and gentlemen, our male junior athlete of the year, Tyler Smith.
Thank you again. In between speeches, I've had time to think a little bit more about what I wanted to say. I would also like to thank the Harbor Swimming Club, as well as Winners Edge Bicycle Association, and again, the Bermuda Triathlon Association. It's been 4 triathletes getting awards so far this night, and I think that's a testament to how great of an organization it really is. And I'm grateful to be a part of it, and again, thank you to my parents. Thank you.
You know, tell me how you're feeling right now.
This is perhaps the proudest day of my life, definitely of my sporting career. To get a recognition like this in Bermuda, it's just fantastic for me, and I'm again so grateful, as I was with the other awards. But this Junior Athlete of the Year, it means so much to me. So happy that my efforts are paying off, and trying to see where they'll take me in the future.
Female Athlete of the Year nominee, Karen Smith. Our first nominee for the Female Athlete of the Year hails from the sport of triathlon. Recapping Karen's year, she won every local event she participated in, both sprint and Olympic distances. These events included the Jackie Triathlon, the Catlin National Olympics Championships, the Aon National Sprint Championships, and the Bank of Bermuda Race. On the international scene, she placed 8th in her age group during the Ironman 70.3 World Championships in Quebec. First, at the Ironman Los Colas in Mexico in the 45 to 49 age group, and the first at the Ironman World Championship in Hawaii. Tonight, we congratulate Karen Smith on her nomination. Flora Duffy, our final nominee for the Female Athlete of the Year award, comes to us from the sport of triathlon. Recapping a great year for Flora, she participated in 16 events throughout the world. In February, she competed in the Xterra World Championships held in Cape Town, South Africa, placing first. She also had a series of first place positions in the same event at the U.S. Southeast Championships, the U.S. East Championships, and the U.S. Championships in Utah. Other notable performances by Flora were at the Scotland Commonwealth Games, where she placed 8th in the ITU and 1st during the Xterra World Championship in October, held in Hawaii. Tonight, we congratulate Flora Duffy on her nomination.
At this time, I'd like to invite. The smoke is getting to me, guys. I'm not even high yet. At this time, I'd like to invite to the stage representing our premier who could not be here tonight, MP Jeff Souza, who will make the presentation on the premier's behalf. Thank you, sir. Mr. Souza, Madam Premier, guests, ladies and gentlemen. We did female, right? It's female, right?
Yeah.
I'm getting a little confused. I am getting high. Our female athlete of the year, Flora Duffy.
Alive. Don't worry about me and who I fire. I get what I desire, it's my empire. And yes, I call the shots, I am the umpire. I sprinkle holy water upon the vampire. In this very moment, I'm king. In this very moment, I slay Goliath with a sling. This very moment, I bring, put it on everything. That I will retire with the ring, and I will retire with the crown. Yes, no, I'm not lucky, I'm blessed. Yes. Clap for the heavyweight champ, me. But I couldn't do it all alone. We, young money.
Yeah, I've always wanted to be escorted onto a stage with a group of lovely young women bearing flags, and tonight, that's it. This is a bit presumptuous, but I did write something. So thanks very much on Flora's behalf to everybody. I suggested to Flora that probably everybody here, at least, is pretty familiar with her results. So maybe we should try and give you a glimpse of the inner Flora, and by reading out a message she sent to the Youth Olympic team, including Tyler over there. And here it is. Embrace each and every experience, for a mind that is stretched by a new experience can never go back to its old dimensions. I'm cheering for you. Bermuda is cheering for you. So go on, thrive in the moment, race fast, and enjoy the details. And hopefully the team found that inspiring. I thought it was kind of cool. Thank you. I paused for applause there. Did you see that? If you've listened to any of Flora's interviews, and she does quite a lot, you know that she boosts Bermuda at every opportunity she gets. She's very proud of Bermuda and proud to be a Bermudian, and she'll be very touched and proud and grateful for the recognition that she's received tonight, so thanks once again. You know, we share all the ups and downs with Flora, and she's had some major downs. Right now, she's just doing incredibly well. You know, last 2 weeks ago in Abu Dhabi, she just shocked everybody, including herself. I think I said this before. And she's third in a field of that included 14 of the top 20 women in the world. So, you know, I don't know how much better she can get. But.
Male Athlete of the Year nominee, Tyler Butterfield. Our first nominee for the Male Athlete of the Year award comes to us from the sport of triathlon. During this past sports year, Tyler participated in 10 events throughout the world. In March of 2014, he participated in the Abu Dhabi International Long Course and placed first overall. And during the Ironman Nice International Long Course held in Nice, France, he finished in third place. While not solely connected to triathlon events, the multiple skills he possesses earned him the winning position during the 2014 Bermuda Day Marathon along with the Cycling Sprint Championship held in Bermuda. So we'd like to extend a heartfelt congratulations to Tyler Butterfield for his nomination. Roy Allen Birch. Our next nominee for the Male Athlete of the Year Award comes to us from the sport of swimming. Roy Allen, a two-time Olympian, represented Bermuda in the 2008 and 2012 Olympics. In August, he placed ninth in the 50-meter freestyle at the Glasgow Commonwealth Games, placed fifth in the same event in November during the CAC Games in Mexico, and finally set five short course national records and five long course national records here in Bermuda. For these accomplishments, we extend a warm congratulations to Roy Allen Birch for his nomination. Santwali Woolridge. And finally, our last nominee for the Male Athlete of the Year Award comes from the sport of Wushu Martial Arts. During the year, our recipient represented Bermuda in the international arena at the 10th Annual Pan-American Wushu Championships in Costa Rica and came first in his weight class. At the 7th Annual Sanda World Cup on Jakarta, he placed second and first at the 1st Annual Pan-American Sanda Cup in Mexico. With great pleasure, we congratulate Santwali Woolridge for his nomination.
Our Male Athlete of the Year, Tyler Butterfield.
Well, I'm surprised. He was up against some tough competition there, and that was, I'm sure, a very challenging decision how to come to this. Anyway, it's an honor. I would like to thank the Bermuda Olympic Association, the Bermuda Triathlon Association, the Bermuda Bicycle Association. I especially would like to thank Dave Morrison and Neil Desenqua, who really got Tyler back into this sport when he was a youngster. Greg Hopkins did an amazing job helping him with cycling and his professional career there. And Patty Petty, he would never have gotten to any of the events had Patty not helped him get into the events as well as get there. So there are many, many people. And then, of course, Tokyo Millennium and many of his sponsors. I thank you very much. It is an honor. I'm sorry he's not here. He, too, would have just loved those flags coming up with and like Charlie, it's fun. thank you, Bermuda. We really appreciate it.
Last year, your husband did the honors. I said, this year, I guess he said, look, it's your turn this year. So tell me, you know, how does it feel to, you know, walk up there and receive this on behalf of your son?
Well, it's an honor. And we want to thank all of Bermuda. I'm very proud of Tyler. He's worked hard, but he's had a lot of people to support him and encourage him and see him get this far. I am sorry he's not here to accept this on his behalf, but it was an honor for me to be able to do that. So thank you.
At this time, we would re-invite back to the stage the Minister for Community Affairs and Sport, the Honorable Pat Gordon Pamplin, to give a few closing remarks.
All I can say at this stage, ladies and gentlemen, is wow. This has been an extreme honor and privilege for me to preside over the first sports awards under my my ministerial duties as the Minister for Community, Culture, and Sport. Let me just mention that I want to give special thanks to MP Jeff Souza, who stood in for Junior Minister Nandi Outerbridge, who had been designated to do the awards for the Senior Male and Female Athlete of the Year on behalf of the Premier. The Premier does send his regrets that he had to travel, because he is one person who likes to be in the midst to ensure that the encouragement that is needed for all of our young people is spoken and is felt. His sincerity in supporting our young people is second to none. Let me also say that some of the things that have come out of tonight have really, really touched me, particularly the comment made by Mr. Stanford Bean, whose comment that sports is a strategic partnership for realizing talent. I think that that's a motto that we can use in our pursuit of excellence for all of our athletes. I also believe that sport brings together the fiercest of adversaries and finds that common ground, notwithstanding the differences that we might have. Let me also say that in order to be effective for sports, we've seen the gamut tonight in terms of those people who have put their benevolence to funding certain the sports, to the parents and the coaches and teammates who have supported our athletes, to the athletes themselves who have put out their level of excellence and dedication to their own craft. I've had the privilege over the course of even just this past week and a half to witness so many different sports and to realize the talents of our young people and the pride that we can feel in each and every one of them as Bermudians as they all step out on the world stage as Bermudian representatives. I think it's also important, if I might share with you, and being very selfish here, growing up in the home in which I did, there were certain standards that were taught to us. And obviously one of them was give your very best. If you're going to be an athlete, train hard, do hard, leave it all on the field. And I've had the privilege of so doing as a representative of Bermuda in international softball competition. I see one of my fellow representatives, Ellen Kate Horton, here. You know, these are the sorts of friendships that actually are able to be fostered by giving of yourself. What I also am very impressed with is the level of giving back. As I speak to every young athlete today, I say to them that when your days of competition are finished, feel free and feel obligated to give back to the country, because in order for you to reach the pinnacle where you have reached, somebody struggled and sacrificed for you. Feel free to give back. And I honor and applaud everyone that we've seen tonight who has given back. But I want to give a word in closing to those athletes who haven't quite reached the pinnacle. It's going to be that additional attempt, that additional determination that will get you there. And I'm going to share with you a poem that sat on the walls of my home with which I grew up from the time I was knee-high to the grasshopper. And it's one that I've tried to live by in terms of trying to encourage people. And it's called The Test. And it goes like this. The test of a man is the fight he makes, the grit that he daily shows, the way he stands on his feet and takes life's numerous bumps and blows. A coward can smile when there's naught to fear, when nothing his progress bars. But it takes a man to stand and cheer while the other fellow stars. It isn't the victory after all, but the fight a brother makes. The man who, driven against the wall, still stands erect and takes the blows of fate with his head held high, bleeding and bruised and pale, is the man who'll win and fate defy, for he isn't afraid to fail. It's the hurdles you mount and the breaks you get and the shucks your courage stand, the hour of sorrow and vain regret for the prize that escapes your hands that tests your mettle and proves your worth. It isn't the blows you deal, but the blows you take on this good old earth that shows if your stuff is real. By our athletes tonight, who have not always come to the top of the podium at first attempt, we have seen their determination. We have seen what they have put into their craft in order to make it to the pinnacle. And for those of you who strive to be there, just know that there's a poem that supports you, there's a country that supports you, and there's certainly a government and a sports minister who supports you. Thank you, and God bless you.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, it's the end of the event for 2015. We'd like to say congratulations to all the successful athletes. And I'd like to ditto the comments just made by the minister for those who haven't quite reached that level yet. The athletes are invited to come to the stage afterwards with your awards so that a group picture can be taken. And again, thank you ever so much for coming. We look forward to seeing you again next year.
We'd like all of you to join us outside for refreshments. And Minister, in closing, we're already looking forward to the 35th annual. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for your attention. We hope you enjoyed the program. Have a wonderful evening.
Have a good night.
I want to ask you, how did you enjoy the show and your reflections on the 34th annual Sports Awards, Minister?
You know, it's the first that I've had the privilege of presiding over, but I think to be in the midst of the excellence that I was, privileged to see tonight, it was just absolutely amazing. I think our athletes just acquit themselves better and better every year. And, you know, we have gotten out there where people are starting to look to Bermuda. Look at the likes of Flora Duffy. We look at Butterfield. You know, these are athletes whose names just roll off the lips on the international scene. And I'm just so proud of them, and I'm so proud to be Bermudian. When I look at Kyra Scraters, you know, our athletes of the year, young man Smith, I mean, what can you say? What can you say? And when you see an athlete who can stand on the stage and say, you know, I'm receiving this award from my mom, you can see the depth of excellence within that family, the determination for, you know, to be able to be at the pinnacle of athleticism. And I'm just so proud of every single person who walked across that stage tonight.
Thank you, Minister. You're so right. It was a beautiful evening, and their conversation, along with their athletic performances, were outstanding. Mr. Souza.
Yes.
How about your reflection, sir? What did you think?
Good evening. I was certainly honored to present tonight on behalf of the Premier Michael Dunkley, who I know is an awesome sportsman himself, and he certainly would have liked to have been here. And what you saw in the room tonight was really family. You know, as I mentioned to you, I'm remembering you from basketball some time ago, and I was taking my son down to basketball. Of course, I saw my father up on the screen, and of course that, you know, really, you know, was important. Bermuda's a small community, and sports is important in Bermuda, like its culture, and it really brings it together as a people. And it's amazing the talent that we have. I, like the minister, was at Carifta Games, you know, and the Island Games, and to see, you know, the young man win the triple jump, and of course Brian Wellman was there tonight. The talent we have in Bermuda is truly amazing. I don't know if it's the cedar bark, or the smell of the oleanders or the ocean, but the talent that we have of a population of 60,000 people is amazing. And repeating what the minister says, and I mean this with all my heart, it truly made me proud to be Bermudian tonight.
Well, thank you, sir. Minister, thank you. We appreciate your participation.
Thank you. You and Deb did a fabulous job. Very, very proud of you as well.
Awesome. Appreciate that.
Awesome.
All right. Thank you.